morning, students. In the last session, we have learnt the formula for trigonometric ratios of compound angles and also how to transform sum of two trigonometric ratios or difference of two trigonometric ratios into product. That is, we have discussed the questions based on the formula, that is sin c plus sin d, sin c minus sin d, cos c plus cos d, and cos c minus cos d. So we have learned sin c plus sin d is equal to 2 sin c plus d by 2 cos c minus d by 2. 2 sin c plus sin d gives 2 sin c plus d by 2 cos c minus d by 2. Sin c minus sin d gives 2 cos c plus d by 2 sin c minus d by 2. Cos c plus cos d gives 2 cos c plus d by 2 cos c minus d by 2. And cos c minus cos d gives 2 sin c plus d by 2 sin d minus c upon 2. In this we have learned, we have discussed here the input session, we put CD is the input, and the output is C plus D upon 2, C minus D upon 2, right? Then this was, when we move in this direction, it is transformation of, when we move in this direction, this one is transform sum or difference into product. When we move in this direction, the input here will be a comma b, and the output will be a plus b comma a minus b. And here this will be used to transform product into sum or difference. So that the formula becomes transformation of product into sum or difference. The formula will be 2 sin A cos B is equal to sin A plus B plus sin A minus B. 2 cos A sin B is equal to sin A plus B minus sin A minus B. 2 cos A cos B is equal to cos A plus B plus cos A minus B, and 2 sin A sin B is equal to cos A minus B minus cos A plus B. यहाँ पे चूंकि स्टार लगा हुआ था, तो ये स्टार लगाने का मतलब था यहाँ पर कि यहाँ बाकी तीन फॉर्मूले में पहले a प्लस बी लिखा है और बाद में a माइनस बी, जबकि ये जो लास्ट फार्मूला है साइन साइन, इसमें पहले a माइनस बी आएगा और फिर a प्लस बी. और लास्ट वाले फार्मूले को हम ऐसे भी लिख सकते हैं, माइनस टू साइन a साइन b इज इक्वल टू कॉस a प्लस बी माइनस कॉस a माइनस बी. सो दीज आर द फोर फार्मूला which will transform product into sum or difference. So now today we'll learn how to apply this formula along with the previous one which we have learned in the last two sessions. Right? Let's see some questions based on this. How to transform product into sum or difference. Right, students, note down the formula. Note down this short trick which we have discussed in the last session also. It will be helpful for you to remember 8 formula. From this, it is CD, and from this side, it is AB. From this side, it is transformation of sum or difference into product, and from this side, it is transformation of product into sum or difference. Right? So let's proceed with some examples. A very simple one. If you have, the question is, convert the following products into sum or difference. I'll take one example for each formula. The first one is 2 sine 5 theta cos theta. 2 sine 5 theta cos theta. Second is sine 7 theta sine 3 theta. Third one is cos 10 theta sine 4 theta, and the fourth one is cos 8 theta cos 3 theta. Okay, now in the first one we have it in the form of 2 sine A cos B. 2 is already multiplied there. Formula used will be 2 sine A cos B is equal to sine A plus B plus sine A minus B. So using this formula, A is equal to 5 theta, B is equal to theta. So here we'll get sine A plus B 5 theta plus theta plus sine 5 theta minus theta, which is equal to sine 6 theta plus sine 4 theta, and this is your answer. 2 sine A sine B. 2 sine A sine B, but here we only have sine A sine B. So what we do, multiply and divide by 2. So this can be written as 1 upon 2 2 sine 7 theta sine 3 theta. Now this is in the form of 2 sine A sine B. 2 sine A sine B is cos A minus B minus cos A plus B. So using this, we get here half cos A minus B 7 theta minus 3 theta. माइनस कॉस ए प्लस बी सेवन थीटा प्लस थ्री थीटा, सो दिस इज इक्वल टू हाफ कॉस फोर थीटा माइनस कॉस टेन थीटा एंड दिस इज द आंसर. सिमिलरली हियर ऑल्सो, अगेन हियर वी हैव ओनली कॉस ए साइन बी, सो मल्टीप्लाई एंड डिवाइड बाई टू, वन अपॉन टू, टू कॉस टेन थीटा साइन फोर थीटा, टू कॉस ए साइन बी, द फॉर्मूला इज साइन ए प्लस बी माइनस साइन ए माइनस बी. सो यूजिंग दिस फॉर्मूला हियर विल गेट हाफ साइन ए प्लस बी साइन टेन थीटा प्लस फोर थीटा साइन फोर्टीन थीटा माइनस साइन ए माइनस बी टेन थीटा माइनस फोर थीटा साइन सिक्स थीटा, राइट. दिस इज द आंसर. लास्ट वन अगेन, अगेन हियर वी हैव कॉस एट थीटा कॉस थ्री थीटा, सो अगेन मल्टीप्लाई एंड डिवाइड बाय टू, वन अपॉन टू, टू कॉस एट थीटा कॉस थ्री थीटा, अगेन टू कॉस ए कॉस बी. द फॉर्मूला यूज दिस टू कॉस ए कॉस बी इज इक्वल टू कॉस ए प्लस बी प्लस कॉस ए माइनस बी. सो दिस इज अप्लाइंग दिस फॉर्मूला विल गेट दिस एज हाफ कॉस ए प्लस बी एट थीटा प्लस थ्री थीटा इलेवन थीटा प्लस कॉस ए माइनस बी एट थीटा माइनस थ्री थीटा दैट इज फाइव थीटा. सो दिस इज द आंसर. सो इन दिस फोर एग्जाम्पल्स वी हैव लर्न्ड हाउ टू अप्लाई दिस, हाउ टू कन्वर्ट द गिवन प्रोडक्ट्स इन द फॉर्म ऑफ सम और डिफरेंस. लेट्स टेक सम मोर एग्जाम्पल्स. Now the next question okay, let's solve some more examples. Another example is 2 cos pi by 13. Cos pi by 13 cos 9 pi by 13 plus cos 3 pi by 13 plus cos 5 pi by 13 equal to 0. This is to be proved. Left hand side of the question is 2 cos pi by 13 cos 9 pi by 13 plus cos 3 pi by 13 plus cos 5 pi by 13. So you see here, this is in the form of 2 cos A cos B. So using the formula 2 cos A cos B is equal to cos A plus B plus cos A minus B. So here we get cos A plus B pi by 13 plus 9 pi by 13 plus cos A minus B पाई बाय 13 माइनस 9 पाई बाय 13 प्लस कॉस 3 पाई बाय 13 एज इट इज प्लस कॉस 5 पाई बाय 13 एज इट इज. सो हियर वी गेट कॉस पाई प्लस 9 पाई 10 पाई बाय 13 प्लस कॉस ऑफ माइनस 8 पाई बाय 13 प्लस कॉस 3 पाई बाय 13 प्लस कॉस 5 पाई बाय 13. नाउ हियर वी हैव फ्रॉम दिस वी कैन सॉल्व दिस क्वेश्चन इन टू डिफरेंट वेज. नाउ यू सी हियर 10 पाई बाय 13 प्लस 3 पाई बाय 13 that will be pi and 8 pi by 13 plus 5 pi by 13 it is also pi. So we can rearrange the terms. From here we can solve this question in two methods. So I am taking the first method here, that is I'll rearrange the terms and apply the formula cos c plus cos d. So here we get cos 10 pi by 13 plus cos 3 pi by 13 plus here cos of minus theta is cos theta, so here we'll get only cos 8 pi by 13 plus cos 5 pi by 13. Now let's make the pairs here. See this one, in both the cases sum is equal to pi. So both this will apply the formula cos c plus cos d, 2 cos c plus d by 2 cos c minus d by 2. So here we get 2 cos c plus d by 2 10 pi by 13 plus 3 pi by 13 c plus d upon 2 cos c minus d by 2 10 pi by 13 minus 3 pi by 13 upon 2 plus again the same formula 2 cos 8 pi by 13 plus 5 pi by 13 upon 2 cos 8 pi by 13 minus 5 pi by 13 upon 2. So here we get 2, this is pi, pi by 2 only, 2 cos pi by 2 cos 7 pi by 26 plus 2 cos again pi by 2 cos 3 pi by 36 3 pi by 26. Now we know that cos pi by 2 it is actually cos 90 degree and value of cos 90 is 0. So here we simply get 2 into 0, so value of cos pi by 2 is 0. So we get it equal to 0. This is the right hand side of the question. This is one method. Students, note it down. Now let's solve this by second method also. Second method. This the step is exactly the same. Now in second method we have this cos 10 pi by 13 as it is. plus cos 3 pi by 13. This cos 3 pi by 13 can be written as cos pi minus 10 pi by 13, right? Plus cos 8 pi by 13 plus cos, this 5 pi by 13 can be written as pi minus 8 pi by 13. Now here we'll use the formula cos pi minus theta equal to minus cos theta. So here we get cos 10 pi by 13 minus cos 10 pi by 13 plus cos 8 pi by 13 minus cos 8 pi by 13. So all these terms get cancelled and the value comes out to be 0. You may use any of the two methods, whichever you find easier. Right? Next example, which is a very important example, and definitely this type of question may be asked in the exam as well. A very important question. And students, I'll give you some more examples, such examples for practice as well. So example number 3. Example number 3. Prove that sine 10 degree, cos 20, cos 40. We'll take two questions here. Cos 20, cos 40. Cos 60, cos 80. Equal to 1 upon 60. And the other one. Or sine 10. Sine 30. Sine 50, sine 70 is equal to 1 by 16. Both these questions have the same solution. May have the same solution. So let's solve. See, this is cos 80 got converted into sine 10. Cos 60 is sine 30. Cos 40 is sin 50 and cos 20 is sin 70. Right? So, let's solve this. Cos 20, left hand side. Cos 20. Cos 40. Cos 80. Cos 60. First we put the value of cos 60, which is equal to 1 by 2. So I have written here 1 upon 2 for cos 60. Now these two will group together because we only have the formula for 2 cos A cos B. I'll write it as cos 40, cos 20 and here it is, cos 80. Now in this bracket, here multiply and divide by 2. So 1 by 2 we already have. We'll divide it by 2. So 1 by 2 again. 2 cos 40, cos 20, multiplied by cos 80. So 1 by 2 into 1 by 2, it is 1 by 4. Now here we use the formula. 2 cos A cos B is equal to cos A plus B plus cos A minus B. Using this formula, here we'll get cos A plus B 40 plus 20 60 plus cos A minus B 40 minus 20 20 multiplied by cos 80 again 1 upon 4. Now we put the value of cos 60 again. We'll go on putting, substituting the known values. Cos 60, 1 by 2, plus cos 20, whole multiplied by cos 80. Now when we take the LCM here, here we get 1 upon 8, and this is, and cos 80 multiplied into the bracket. Cos 80 plus 2 cos 80 cos 20. Here again we use the same formula, 1 upon each cos 80 as it is plus 2 cos A cos B, again cos A plus B plus cos A minus B, cos A plus B, so 80 plus 20 100 plus cos A minus B, 80 minus 20 is 60. Now this 80, 1 upon each as it is, 80 can be written as 90 minus 10, and 100 can be written as 90 plus 10 plus cos 60 is 1 by 2. Now we have cos 90 minus theta is sin theta, and cos 90 plus theta is minus sin theta. So here we get 1 upon each as it is, sin 10 minus sin 10 plus 1 upon 2. This gets cancelled, 1 by 8 into 1 by 2, that is 1 upon 16, which is the right hand side of the question. So this way we have solved by converting this given expression, given as product, into sum, and then we have simplified it to get the required value. Then let's solve one more question. Now if you have this question as sin 10, sin 30, sin 50, sin 70, so what you can do, convert this in the form of cos and then proceed as it is. As here, as we have discussed, sin 10 will be equal to cos 80, sin 30 is cos 60, sin 50 is cos 40, sin 70 is cos 20, and we can proceed it as it is. Or the other way, what you can do, as we have done this question, you can try yourself, put the value of sin 30 as 1 by 2, then make the pairs of these two, that is sin 10, sin 50, multiply and divide by 2. So you will get the similar situation again. Now in that case, we'll apply the formula 2 sin A sin B, which is equal to cos A minus B minus cos A plus B. Proceeding in the same way, again we apply the same formula once more, and we approach to the result, that is 1 by 16. So students, try yourself this one, right? Let's take another example, one more example for this. तो स्टूडेंट्स एग्जाम्पल नंबर फोर, एग्जाम्पल नंबर फोर, साइन 20 साइन 40 साइन 60 साइन 80 इक्वल टू 3/16। Similar way, this is the known value here, sine 60, value is root 3 upon 2, so I'll write here root 3 upon 2, root 3 upon 2, then multiply and divide by 2, so into 1 by 2, 2 sine 40 sine 20 sine 80, this is root 3 upon 4 now, 2 sine A sine B, 2 sine A sine B, is, okay, let's write it as 20-40, sine 20 sine 40, 2 sin A sin B is cos A minus B minus cos A plus B. Okay, let's write the bigger angle first. So that will be 40 and 20 here. Okay. So applying this formula, root 3 upon 4. 2 sin A sin B cos A minus B minus cos A plus B cos A minus B 40 minus 20 20 minus cos A plus B 40 plus 20 40 plus 20 is cos 60 multiplied by sin 80 root 3 upon 4 cos 20 minus value of cos 60 is 1 upon 2 sin 80. Now taking LCM and multiplying sin 80 into the bracket. So we get root 3 upon 8. 2 sin 80 cos 20 minus sin 80. Now here, we apply the formula 2 sin A cos B, which is equal to sin A plus B plus sin A minus B. So here we get root 3 upon 8, sin A plus B, sin 100 degree. Plus sin A minus B, 80 minus 20, 60, minus sin 80, root 3 upon 8. Now this sin 100, either it can be written as 90 plus 10, and this one can be written as 90 minus 10, or 180. We can also write it as 180 minus 80 plus root 3 upon 2 minus sin 80. Sin 180 minus theta is sin theta. So that we get root 3 upon 8 sin 80 plus root 3 upon 2 minus sin 80 plus sin 80 minus sin 80 cancel, root 3 by 8 into root 3 by 2, which comes out to be 3 upon 60, right? So this way we can solve this type of questions. Next one. Then next question, four sine theta or sine A. Okay, let's take it for 10, 20 for tan theta. Next example, 10, 20, 10, 40, 10, 80. Only it is 10, 20, 10, 40, 10, 80. And this is to be proved only equal to 10, 60 or root 3 only. So here, in this question, what we need to do, we'll write the left hand side in terms of sine theta and cos theta. So this will be sine 20, sine 40, sine 80 upon cos 20, cos 40, cos 80. Now multiply numerator and denominator by 2, sine 40, sine 20, sine 80 as it is, upon 2, cos 40, cos 20, cos 80 as it is. Now in the numerator we apply the formula 2 sin A sin B. 2 sin A sin B equal to cos A minus B minus cos A plus B. And here we'll apply 2 cos A cos B. 2 cos A cos B cos A plus B plus cos A minus B. So this formula will be applied in the numerator and this will be applied in the denominator. Applying this formula, cos A minus B 40 minus 20 cos 20 minus cos A plus B 40 plus 20 cos 60 sin 80 as it is upon cos A plus B cos 60 plus cos A minus B 40 minus 20 20 cos 80 B. Right. So this is equal to cos 20. Cos 20 as it is minus value of cos 60 1 upon 2 sin 80 upon cos 60 1 by 2 plus cos 20 cos 80 as it is. Now let's take LCM and multiply sin 80 into the bracket here and cos 80. So here we get 2 sin 80 cos 20 minus sin 80 upon cos 80 plus 2 cos 80 cos 20 okay upon 2 gets cancelled. Now here see this question. In this question, we have used 2 sin A sin B. We have used 2 cos A cos B. Now we'll use 2 sin A cos B and 2 cos A cos B again. तीन फॉर्मूले इसमें यूज हो रहा है. तो यहाँ पे न्यूमरेटर में आपका 2 sin A cos B लगी था. 2 sin A cos B, which is equal to sin A plus B. Plus sin a minus b. This will be applied only in the numerator. और denominator में आपका 2 cos a cos b ही लगेगा. तो यहाँ से formula apply करते हैं. Sin a plus b मतलब sin 100 degree. Okay? Plus sin a minus b मतलब sin 60 degree. Minus sin 80. 80 को हम लिख सकते हैं 180 माइनस 100, 100 में कन्वर्ट कर दिया. कॉस 80 को हम लिख सकते हैं कॉस 180 माइनस 100. 2 कॉस ए कॉस बी, कॉस ए प्लस बी, कॉस ए प्लस बी 80 प्लस 20 100 प्लस कॉस ए माइनस बी 80 minus 20, 60. Now here, sin 180 minus theta is sin theta and cos 180 minus theta is minus cos theta. तो ये दोनों फॉर्मूले जब हम यहां अप्लाई करते हैं तो sin 100 as it is प्लस साइन 60 की वैल्यू रूट 3/2 माइनस 180 माइनस थीटा साइन थीटा दिया जाएगा साइन 100 अपॉन कॉस 180 माइनस थीटा माइनस कॉस थीटा ये हो गया माइनस कॉस 100 प्लस कॉस 100 प्लस कॉस 60 की वैल्यू 1/2 साइन 100 साइन 100 कॉस 100 कॉस 100 कैंसिल रूट 3/2 अपॉन 1/2 विच इज इक्वल टू रूट 3 और ये रूट 3 आपकी वैल्यू होती है टेन 60 डिग्री की. हेंस इट इज प्रूव. सो स्टूडेंट्स जस्ट सॉल्व दीज क्वेश्चंस, वॉच द वीडियो, सब्सक्राइब द चैनल मैथ्स बाय प्रदीप बर्डे एंड don't forget to click on the bell icon. I'll be continuing to uploading the videos on my channel, that is Maths by Pradeep Burde. So subscribe the channel and enjoy the videos and continue your learning also during your summer vacations. Thank you.